fifth chapter, The Flowering of Consciousness. When our subconscious mind sends the impulses to do a wrong thing, what shall we do? Is it good for the conscious mind to accept the impulses to do a wrong thing? Is it right for the conscious mind to execute the impulse and do a wrong thing? Here, we have to think about and consider various other factors also. We are living in a society where so many people are leading their lives. Everyone has one's own interests. There are various kinds of people and different types of works. So, a society can be maintained without any friction only by way of some social norms. Otherwise, there would be utter chaos and confusion. If we think of traveling, we have to follow the traffic rules. In the same way, we have to accept the social order. Then only will a society function peacefully. Our consciousness, as we have seen, is only our physical expression. It comes and goes within the body. The conscious expressions are felt within the body and mind. It is only an inward action. We may have the feeling of hatred, agony, or fear within our mind. We have to do nothing about it. If we do anything against our agony or fear, it is not but inviting trouble within ourselves. So, we have to accept everything as it comes within our mind. But should we apply the same rule to an external situation? We should not keep ourselves mum, accepting and taking everything as it comes. Our outward action is determined by the outward situation where we are placed. We have to act externally as a diligent person. If the situation requires our effort to work and modify the situation, we have to work to change it. We should not allow the situation as it is. We need not accept the situation as it is. But our inward mental activities are different, where we have to accept everything as our nature. We should not take any responsibility to change our inward feelings. What shall we do if our inner feelings are closely related to outward things? For example, I feel angry at the wrongdoings of my neighbor. What shall I do? The anger is natural. I have to accept it. I should not wage a war against my anger. Since it is an inward feeling, I have to accept it inwardly. Does it mean that I may have a quarrel with my neighbor? No, it is not so. We have to adjust with all our neighbors. We have to maintain a good relationship with everyone. We have to follow all the social conducts since the situation is so required from everybody. But inwardly, we should not have any conduct to follow and confirm. For example, we are standing in the open terrace of a multi-story building. Suppose we think, what will happen if I jump down from the terrace? Nothing will happen, for we will never execute this thought into action, and we will simply dismiss the thought as a passing cloud. In the same way, all of our conscious feelings are nothing but passing clouds. We need not fight with any one of such passing consciousness. Everything comes spontaneously. If we do not disturb it positively or negatively, it goes away spontaneously as it comes. But outward action is something different. One must act according to the situation where one is placed. He must act as a prudent man in that situation. He must do what is right and good. For external actions, there is good and bad, right and wrong. Everyone has the duty to do the right thing, otherwise chaos would be the inevitable outcome in the world. But inwardly, we have no duty to correct our consciousness. There is no right consciousness or wrong consciousness. There is no good consciousness or bad consciousness. There is only a passing consciousness. It will come spontaneously and will end spontaneously. If we enter with a theory or an idea to change it or to retain it, there will arise all the troubles. If we fight with our feelings throughout our life, and there would be no end for that. So all our conscious feelings are of equal nature. There is no higher or lower consciousness. There is no ordinary or divine consciousness. If we begin to select our conscious feelings to be right or wrong, then trouble is inevitable. Ignorance is inevitable. Spiritual consciousness, no doubt, is regarded as a divine one. Let it be. Let it come and go. If anything comes, let it come spontaneously. What we have to do is that we should not have any attachment to our feelings, whether it is divine or ordinary. When we are not attached to any one of our conscious feelings, what will happen to our mind? Under these circumstances, our mind itself undergoes a radical change. But we do not have any role in that change of mind. It happens by itself. It is the nature of our mind to undergo a change. As the conscious mind and the subconscious mind are in war with each other, the entire life of an ordinary person is caught in troubles. Actually, the subconscious mind does not come to the scene at all. It produces the conscious mind, and afterwards it keeps itself out of reach. Only the conscious mind itself fights against its own feelings. The duty of subconscious mind is over when it produces the conscious mind. Afterwards, the conscious mind fights against its own movements. The conscious mind fights against itself. It is a self-contradiction within itself. Self-contradiction is the basic reason for all our troubles. Self-contradiction is the real problem. It may appear wrong if one is asked to accept his consciousness of hatred, anger, and so on. It looks wrong to say that one should not resist his bad qualities like hatred, anger, envy, and so on. But such qualities are our actual consciousness. We ourselves are nothing but this consciousness. By resisting such consciousness, we are covering the actual consciousness with the thought, "I should not have such feeling anymore." The consciousness is actual, and the thought to control it is only an imagination, because all thoughts are imaginary. When we have a thought to control our consciousness of bad qualities, we have a satisfaction that we are noble and that we are resisting ignoble consciousness. But ignoble consciousness is our actual nature as we experience it. By our thinking of resisting such bad qualities, we have wasted our life so far without any direct insight into the real problem. We resist our consciousness of bad qualities not only for satisfaction, but also for some other reasons. We imagine and are afraid that we do not resist it. The consciousness of bad qualities will be expressed as outward action. For example, I have consciousness of anger. The anger is expressed as my consciousness in a given situation. If I don't have the thought to control it, I think I would show my anger towards the people around me and I would create an awkward situation around me. Here, physical action is involved. So, it is right and necessary to have a thought to control our feelings so that I won't do any harm to the people around me and will get myself protected from the people around me. The outward actions are governed by social norms and regulations. We are not against such kind of thought of regulating our behavior with our people or in a given situation. There must be a regulating thought, otherwise one could be considered as mad. When we are in anger, the thinking that the anger is wrong and we must be free from anger is wrong. This is very important to be considered deeply. So, whatever may be our consciousness, whether it may be noble or ignoble, it must be accepted wholeheartedly. It must be allowed as passing clouds. It does not mean that we are approving our bad qualities. We ask to accept it only for the purification of the basic structure of our entire field of consciousness. Our consciousness may look awkward and bad, but its potentiality is different. If we allow it to flower, it will produce wonders. The agitation against our consciousness in the expectation of making it good makes one life troublesome. To accept our consciousness as it is without any effort to modify it is the correct understanding. Such understanding is the perfect understanding. This is what enlightenment is. This understanding is very, very simple. But one must confirm with oneself that this is enlightenment. Anybody can get this confirmation within himself if he is simple and earnest. It can also be had from another enlightened person. Anyhow, it must be confirmed. Once it is confirmed, everything is over. Then he becomes the nameless flow of life itself. It has neither a beginning nor an end.